Very good morning to all my viewers. First of all, I am thankful and grateful to all my viewers who keep supporting and watching my all videos. Your support boosts me to make the different videos. So, welcome again back to my channel. My name is Anand Kaushal, and in this video, I am going to talk about the different mechanical equipments which are used in housekeeping. Two types of equipments. The first is manual equipments and the second is mechanical equipments. We will discuss about the manual equipment first. Manual equipments are those equipments which help in the cleaning process by directly using manual energy of the employees. There are the various manual equipments available, out of which the common manual equipments which are used in hotels are brooms, brushes, mops, cloths, containers and box sweepers. Let's discuss one by one about all the manual equipments. The first one is broom. Brooms consist of long bristles gathered together and inserted into a handle. Bristles may be made of grass, corn or coconut fibers. There are different types of brooms. Soft bristle brooms, which are made of corn fiber, grass brooms and used on smooth floors. Hard bristle brooms, coconut fiber brooms or yard brooms, which are used on rough surfaces. And the next one is wall brooms. These are used to remove cobwebs from the ceilings. The next type of manual equipment is brushes. These brushes are designed to remove dust and dirt from different surfaces. The parts of brush are stalk, bristles and handle. A stalk in which bristles are inserted, which are made of wood, metal or plastic. Bristles are made of horsehair, nylon, jute, etc. Handle may also be made of wood or plastic and can be detachable or non-detachable. The different types of brushes which are available are as follows. Hard brush. These are the brushes which are having the stiff bristles and well spaced out, which is used to remove heavy soil from rough surface. Then we have the another type of brush that is called as soft brush. Soft brush consist of softer bristles and are set close together. It helps to remove the loose soil from a smooth surface like carpets, furniture, etc. The third type of brush is scrubbing brush. These have short, hard bristle designed for cleaning stains and heavy soil, also known as tea brushes. Apart from this, the other types of brushes which are available are WC brush, Johnny mops, bottle brushes, cloth scrubbing brush, carpet brush, feather brush, etc. Now we will move to the third type of manual equipment, that is mop. So different types of mops are available, like dry mops and wet mops. What is dry mop? Dry mop are also called as dust control mops. These are used to remove dust from floors, wall ceilings. The mops have handle to which a metal frame is attached. The mop head made of dense cotton fringes are inserted into the frame and stretched over it. Next, we have wet or damp mop. These mops are used along with the buckets to remove dirt from the floor surface. The mop consists of a handle and cotton fringes or a sponge which are capable of absorbing water. The types of damp mop are do-all mops, Kentucky mop, Foss mop, squeezy and sponge mop. Now the fourth category of manual equipment is cloth. The various cloths are used in dry and wet cleaning. For efficient uses, cloth can be color-coded and used by staff for different uses. The different types of cloths which are available are as follows. Number 1. Dusters. These are the soft absorbent plain or checked cotton material used for dusting and buffing. The next type of cloth is swab and wipes. These are made of loosely woven cotton cloth, which are soft absorbent material used for wet cleaning of surface above the floor level, mainly used for cleaning bathtubs and wash basin. The third example or type of cloth is floor cloth. These are coarse knitted cotton cloths which are bigger, thicker and used to clean floors. The next category, glass cloth. These are lint free and is used for cleaning glass and mirror. We have dust sheets which are made of thin cotton material which are discarded from the linen room, like bedsheet or curtains used to cover floor. Next type of or next example of the cloth is cotton rags or cloth, disposable cotton or cloths which are used for applying polishes and cleaning agents. We'll move to the fifth category of manual equipment, that is container. The staff require containers to carry, transport and store items of use and collect waste products. The different types of containers are: number one, bucket. Buckets are made of plastic or galvanized iron, which are used to collect water and used with mops for cleaning. Number two, dust pans, which are used along with the brushes to collect dust and made of plastic or metal. The edge in contact with floor must be thin and sharp to collect the dust easily. The third type of container is dustbin. It is made of plastics or wood, metals, leather, jute and placed in different areas like guest rooms, public areas and all back areas. The next type of container is sani bins, which are made of metal or plastic bins with the lids. Next, under the container, we have a spray bottles. The spray bottles are lightweight containers which deliver a fine mist of water or cleaning solution on the surface to be cleaned. Next, under container, we have hand caddies, which are made of metal, wood or plastic, consist of tray with slots for storing chemical bottles, and it is easy to carry. Next, we have carts and trolleys. Under carts, we have chambermaid's trolley, which is also called as room attendant cart or GRA trolley. Now, this trolley is being used by the guest room attendant for cleaning guest rooms. It is used to carry linen, cleaning agents, supplies, cleaning equipments which are required for the guest room cleaning and stored in the guest corridor and should be movable and strong. The second type of trolley is janitorial trolley, which is used for cleaning and storing cleaning supplies for public area cleaning. The next category is mop wringer trolley. This equipment consists of mop and buckets to carry cleaning solution and clean water, mainly used for public areas. The next type of trolley is linen trolley, which is used for transfer of linen from guest rooms to laundry for washing and are made of cloth or metal with caster wheels. Now, next category under manual equipment is box sweeper. These are manually operated carpet sweepers which are used for removing crumbs from the surfaces. It consists of a brush that revolves when equipment is pushed over the carpet and crumbs get collected in the dust collector pan, which are emptied when filled. So, these are all about manual equipment. The next type or category of equipment are known as mechanical equipments. The mechanical equipments are those equipments which work by motors and powered by electricity or some other external source of energy. The different mechanical equipments are vacuum cleaner, or it is also known as suction cleaner. Vacuum cleaners are used to remove dust and crumbs from the surfaces by suction. Vacuum cleaners can be classified on the basis of shape of the machine, like cylindrical, upright, backpack, dusted, which falls under the examples of shape of the machine. Next, based on the function. Based on the function, the different types of vacuum cleaners are dry pickup, wet pickup, dry and wet pickup, and pile lifter. Then we have centralized vacuuming system. Apart from that, we have cylindrical vacuum cleaner or dry pickup. These machines work by suction. Electricity makes the motor work, and dust is collected by high suction created by the motor and sucked in through the hose and collected in the dust bag which is inside the machine. Next, we have upright vacuum cleaner or dry pickup. The main body of the machine lies horizontally on the surface and does not have attachments but has built-in hose for cleaning corners and upholstery. Mainly it is used for large carpet areas. Then the next type of vacuum cleaner, backpack vacuum cleaner. It is a small lightweight vacuum cleaner which can be strapped at the back and used to clean upholstery and curtains. Next type of vacuum cleaner, dusted, which is small lightweight battery operated vacuum cleaner which are used to vacuum clean upholstery, carpet edges, mattresses, curtain and staircases. It is portable and can be easily carried in hand. Next, we have wet pickup vacuum cleaner. It is used to pick up wet waste, excess waste water, etc. from the floor after scrubbing. This can also be used to remove excess moisture after shampooing the carpet. Next, we have pile lifter. It is a vacuum cleaner with two motors to make it extremely strong on action. The pile of the carpet usually flattens in use. Pile lifter grooms the pile of the carpet and restores their vertical orientation. Next, we have centralized vacuuming. Centralized vacuuming or centralized vacuum cleaning system, suction is generated at one point in a building. Soil is removed by suitable nozzles linked by flexible stretchable hoses to vacuum point. It is then conveyed by a network of pipes to a central container. This system is expensive to install and is generally done at a construction stage. Now, how do we take care and store vacuum cleaner? Wheels should be oiled frequently. After using, dust bags or tanks should be emptied and cleaned. Always clean the attachment heads after cleaning work is over. If machine is dry pickup, never try to pick wet waste. Attachments should be stored in a proper boxes. Now we will talk about the next type of mechanical equipment, which is called as floor maintenance machine. This is a multifunctional machine which can scrub, polish and buff the floors. The machines have driving disc, which comes like single disc or three small disc, which rotates on opposite directions. They have water tank, shampoo tank, sprayer, which are used for different function. For scrubbing and scrubbing is done with a scrubbing brush or with the scrubbing pad attached to the disc which cut the soil. For polishing, red colored pads to be applied. For buffing, white pads are used to create high gloss finish. Next type of mechanical equipment is wet extraction machines. Wet extraction machines are used to restore the surface appearance of carpet, upholstery and curtains. They remove deeply embedded soil not removed by suction cleaning. The types of wet extraction system are hot water extraction machine and solvent extraction machine. Now, next type of mechanical equipment is sampoing machine. In this, brushes are made of nylon as it needs to be strong to get through the carpet pile. They are fixed to the disc of the floor maintenance machine. There are a special pressure tank along with a foam generator which produces the foam in dry form, which cleans the carpet and suspends the soil. This way, carpet does not get too wet. Next category of equipment and or mechanical equipment is power sweeper. These are self or manually operated machines designed to remove debris and loose soil from floor, pavement, car park and large areas. Next mechanical equipment is scarifying machine. Scarifying is a process of removing heavy grease, mud, thick deposits of dirt from floor by chisel-like action with a wire brush cutting tool. So these were about the equipments. Now we are going to talk about how to store and care of cleaning equipments. Equipments should be stored in areas which are locked properly. Proper records of issuing equipments should be maintained, like area, attachment given, time issued, whom issued to, and at what time we have received it back. Next, attachment and parts should be cleaned properly and stored after use. Brushes should never be faced downward in the floor as it would damage the machine or the bristles. Now we will talk about the selection criteria for cleaning equipments. When we are selecting the equipments, the first thing we have to look efficient cleaning and maintenance. Maximum work productivity, depending on high quality cleaning equipments and selecting the ideal equipments. The selection criteria for equipments are safety in operation, suitable to type of area, surface, work, amount of obstruction and cleaning frequency, versatility to do various types of cleaning, work performance in terms of capacity of machine, easy to handle in terms of size, weight, height of machine and ease of operation, portability in terms of ease of transfer between floors and provision of wheels and detachable parts, durability of the equipments, sturdiness, life of the equipment, etc., noise level of the equipment, easy availability of spare parts, protective design of the equipment without sharp edges, easy to store in terms of dismantling parts and storage space required, cost as initial cost, operating cost, maintenance. So these are the few points which we have to keep in mind while selecting the cleaning equipments. So I hope the equipments, different types of equipment, selecting equipments and storing the equipments are clear. Thank you all my viewers for watching this video. Keep supporting me and I will keep posting all the videos which is going to be useful for you all. Thank you.